So one of the questions was from Somay College that flush left, flush right works. What about justification? Yeah, justification means left and right both sides. But I think to the best of my knowledge, LaTeX will always automatically justify it. Now, but we can check that in a document right now. Another comment is that we should start from a new template rather than go by an existing one, and that is indeed a very good comment. So why don't we do that first? Yeah. So let us go to examples. Let's go here. Let's say vim new dot tech. Yeah. Begin. First one is comments. Let's say comments. Any line can be comment, not just first line. First line can also be empty. Document class article, begin document, end document. This is like starting point. Every LaTeX tech file should have at least this. There should be a document class, begin document, end document. Everything else is optional. These three have to be there. Yeah, everything is not optional. For example, there has to be some content. Yeah. What if there are only spaces are there? Will spaces come in the output file? That we will know as soon as we compile it. PDF LaTeX new. It says no pages of output. Empty spaces will not come in a PDF file. Empty lines also will not come. LaTeX thinks there is nothing to do. No output. Yeah. If you put spaces, I am putting some spaces. These are all empty spaces. Still, when you compile, nothing is. But let's say some output had better come. This is what I have typed into the text file. And let's see now. It says one page. Events new dot pdf. See, some output has come now. Finally, yeah. We have started from a blank text file. We have put document class. Article, no options, then begin document, end document. With that much nothing comes, but we put at least this much, and now it has come. What we will do now is we will just copy the same thing. Yeah, 10 times I put the same thing, 10 not larger. Yeah, let us see whether justification automatically happens. Look, see, you see some output has had better come, again same. Now it has also got justified. Yeah, even though one line had, why don't I make the fonts even larger, each line. See, readability of this document is not required. Please don't ask me to make the font larger. If it is on, this is just a sample PDF file that is being shown for demonstration. You do not have to be able to read it. Yeah, if it is something about quotes, you should be able to read, then I will make the fonts larger. Look here, it has already got justified. One line had only this much. Yeah, why did the next line of the text file come as continuation of this? Yeah, you, as long as there is no empty line, let us go back to the text file. This is our text file. As long as there was no empty line, they are all supposed to be continuations. Yeah. Now, but we can leave one empty line. See, look, I left one empty line, and let's go back to the PDF file. It is still one paragraph. Why it is still one paragraph? We have not saved that file. We have not compiled again. PDF file will not change until you save the file and then compile. We have saved the file. Now we have compiled it. Now look, it has become two paragraphs. Yeah, everything from here up to here was one paragraph. Because you left an empty line, it has not left empty line here, but it has put this beginning of the paragraph, that indentation, and it has ended the line. Even if there was some space from here, even if there was some space here still it has gone to a new line. All that has happened only because in the tech file, let us see the tech file again. In the tech file, we left this empty line. Yeah, in this empty line, let me put some spaces. Yeah, lots of spaces. Still, the output will not change. Yeah, we can also put some many new lines. Still, output will not change. See, output is exactly the same. Even though we put one line having many spaces and many empty lines, in spite of that, output is exactly the same. Yeah, is this clear? So, left and right justification always happens default. Yeah, I would say, when would you require no justification? You might require flush left, you might require flush right. That is for lines, that is for those which are not full. Yeah, for example, address on the top, you want to be on the left side. You want the date to be right side maybe. Also, your signature or name, your sincerely, maybe we want flush right. But if the if it's paragraphs, always left and right justification will happen. In fact, I do not know if it can be disabled. If you want to disable it, then you have to put it as separate paragraphs, and you have to, what you have to do is you have to disable this par indent that comes with the new paragraph. Indent paragraph can be removed. That is the only way. And to remove par indent, to make that as 0 points is not difficult. It is doable. But we do not require it here. Okay, this is an example of how we can start from a bare file and put. Now, but then I hope you acknowledge that we have many things to cover, and for me to type them all into the tech file will just take too much time. Yeah, rather than that, we go with the existing tech file. That existing tech file has just few use packages and listings lst set that command for Python it had. Its significance will come when we cover to the, when we reach that topic. Until then, you can comment it out. Okay, let's go to the slides. So we were here before we stopped, that open quote for accent or left quote for opening, and close quote, which actually looks vertical in the tech file, is the one we will use for closing. Also for apostrophe. For double quotes, just use them twice, they will come together close by. Slash emph for emphasis, this also we had started seeing. We will quickly see flush left, flush right, and center environments. Yeah, this is the next thing we will see. Suppose we abstract already comes in the center, begin centered. Every begin should end with the end. Yeah, this is to be centered, this is not to be centered. Yeah, so let us just compile this and see the difference. Whatever content we have put is immediately after the abstract, before the section introduction begins. So, we will compile now. Again, that particular error is there, it has come. Yeah, this is what we were discussing just before the tea break, but I told you that some output will still get generated if you do X, if you do if you press enter. Here is our output. This is to be centered, has certainly got centered. What has not got centered is this, whatever was after the end center. Yeah, and this is not to be centered. What about this space here? This is because it thinks that this is the beginning of a paragraph, yeah, that is why it has indented it. If you do not want this to be indented, this particular thing is not in the slides, but it is getting recorded anyway, it will be available even if you do not take note. If you put no indent, it will remove that. So, we can compile this later and see. What we can also see is, if you put lots of such text, then what happens? Here, this is to be centered, you have put again and again. Yeah. So, up to here it has got left and right justified, but here because the last line did not have enough text, instead of leaving space to the right side, it has left space to the both sides. This is what you can note. Also, there is no indent of the paragraph that it has left, and here also the indent that was there in the beginning of this has been removed. These are the important changes we did to the tech file. But then this, perhaps this is not what you wanted. You wanted this is to be centered on separate lines. So, how do we get it to be on separate lines? Yeah, let us go back to the tech file. This also is to be sent. Suppose these are separate lines. This is yet another to be centered. Individually we want them to be full lines. So, here the last line does not require double slash, because it will anyway end because of this empty line, also because the environment is ending. So, now when you do, this is perhaps what we typically want. Here this is to be centered, this also is to be centered, this is yet another to be centered. Incidentally, this line was longer than this line and it looks like pyramid. Yeah, that is just a coincidence. If you interchange the sequence of lines, then it will not come nice as a pyramid. Yeah, and then this one was outside that center environment, so it has gone to the left, and also it has not left the beginning of the line, beginning of the paragraph indentation, because we put slash no indent command. Why did this indentation not come? After every introduction, whenever introduction begins, it will not put. Whenever chapter begins, whenever section begins, that time it is not the beginning of a new paragraph, but a section, then it will not put. If you want it there, I do not know if some particular format or journal requires that. If you really require an indentation like a paragraph, you can always put some space there. If you want that space to be precisely equal to the indentation of a paragraph, that is also doable. So, first let us just remove this. This is causing, I already told that we do not want the PDF LaTeX to end with errors. It should always come back to the prompt. That is why we removed this. We also want the numbers, let us say. Suppose here we want slash, we want the indentation and slash par indent, paragraph indent. Perhaps I made some other mistake. So, it has not put that slash, it has not put the paragraph indent. Yeah. So, paragraph indent is always going to be ruled out whenever it is the beginning of a section. If you still want some space, then you have to put some edge space, some horizontal space. Perhaps that is the only way it appears. So, let us see why that error came. So, if you force a par indent, it is giving an error, it appears. Yeah, when we do PDF LaTeX now without par indent, then it is compiled and come back to the prompt. Sure, is this clear? Are there any further questions? Somebody had a question, how to add image and graph. This is very important. In our documents we want to have images. About that we will see later. Are there any other questions?
What are the other files to be generated while compiling is PDF LaTeX? AUX file, .AUX file, what is the use of the file?
Yeah, sure. Any other questions?
Sir, for including a figure, is it essential to give the file extension like BMP or JPEG?
So, his question is that when you are including a graphics, then what about the extension? Do we have to give the extension, or is there a default extension it will expect and look for those extensions? So, that is a very important topic, and we will look into that in more detail. That is a very important topic. Any other questions?
Sir, so my question is how to convert LaTeX file into some other format other than PDF.
Okay, thank you for your questions. We will start answering them one by one. Because we have to use push to talk, we recommend that you ask in chat also meanwhile. Yeah, thank you. The next question is from KJ Somaya.
Sir, I have two questions. How to get the particular font, say Times New Roman or Arial or any other font? And second question is, how to make it recognize that text typed in another lipis, for example, Devanagari?
Yeah, thank you very much for this question. We will discuss that in more detail. Yeah, very much. Are there any more questions? Otherwise, we will stop the interaction with Somaya and start answering all the questions we have connected so far.
One more question, sir. When you type a chapter command, after that, whatever the text is there, it's not coming in for paragraphs.
Yes, yes, we will answer that. Yeah.
Paragraph. If you use the chapter command or whatever the section command, after that, whatever the text is there, it's not coming in your paragraphs. And second one question is that flush left allow you to take the content to the left, flush right allow you to content to the right. But if I want to justify particularly some space, I wanted not to that the center.
Can you repeat that last part, that you want neither flush left nor flush right nor center? Sure. Yeah, we will answer that question. Okay, so let us just have a look at the various questions. Somewhere about alignment. So we will quickly see about the alignment in more detail. Then there were some questions about what are the various extensions. Yeah, let us have a look at the various files that have got generated: awk, log, TOC. Then about when you include some figure, then what is the default extension that is there of the image, whatever file we are including. Then there were some questions about IEEE. If you want IEEE style in two columns, how do you do that? That is straightforward. Then how do we have different fonts other than Times Roman? How do you have italics? How do you have other calligraphic, math calligraphic fonts? And how do you write Devanagari? Important. How do you write Devanagari? There are many other Indian scripts that are possible in LaTeX now. And then there was a question about chapter. There is no begin paragraph space after chapter section. How do you actually get the space? We tried par indent, but that did not work. In fact, that gave an error. Yeah. Then there was also a question of how do you, if you do not want flush left or flush right, but you want to move the text by a certain amount to the right or to the left, how do you move it by a certain amount? Yeah. So let us see these one by one. So let us see all the files that are generated. Yeah, glimpse. Then there was also a question about are there any other LaTeX to some other, from tech file instead of PDF file, if you want some other file, for example HTML is also very important, what other files are also possible instead of PDF file. Yeah, so these are the various questions we will start answering one by one. So the first easiest question to answer is, so we wrote our content. We wrote our content in a tech file. Once we wrote the content in a tech file, when we did PDF LaTeX, it generated a PDF file. Yeah. So what are these two other files? Log file is just the information that came on the screen. When you did PDF LaTeX, a lot of information came on the screen. All that information is certainly there in the log file, and some more extra information. And this is just a log. Whenever you run a program, then some log is created. That log is it keeps track of what all happened, all these errors, etc. Everything is there in the log file. If you want to look at the information that came on the screen, you don't have to compile it again. Compiling might be a big task for big documents. What is the awk file? Awk file has this information about page numbers, about various labels. Very soon we will use labels. All those labels and all are going to be stored inside the awk file. AUX stands for auxiliary, actually, even though auxiliary, X is auxiliary, but we normally call it as awk file. Awk, just like LaTeX has a tech as in technology, awk is also AUK, like that. So these are all, awk file has some information. You are recommended to open it and see. It has, in our case, we do not have any labels perhaps. We have a citation, which kept coming as question mark, but that is question mark, it came because we put the end document a little too early. Yeah, once we start seeing references, that time the question mark will be replaced by actually a number. Because we had a section, it has also written this. But even though we don't want the table of contents, it has this command: write file table of contents. Yeah, this particular thing, and this happens to be the page number where that section begins. Of course, you don't want the table of contents. That is why write file is not having an effect, and TOC file has not got generated. When we see the TOC file has not got generated, that is because table of contents has not been demanded. If you put a slash table of contents command, then that TOC file will get generated. As far as just PDF LaTeX is concerned, these files are getting generated. If we do LaTeX, then when we see that it has, we did LaTeX of new file, new.tex file, it has also generated DVI file. DVI stands for device independent, but then I think it is not essential for you to do LaTeX, just do PDF LaTeX. LaTeX is required when you want to use PS tricks. LaTeX used to be there before. After you have a DVI file, one used to make a PDF file directly from DVI by, yeah, this is another way of creating a new dot PDF file. Instead of PDF, you can also make a PS file. This also creates a PS file. You see, now new dot PDF got created first by PDF LaTeX. It got overwritten when we did DVI PDF. But instead of PDF, you might want PS file. So DVI PS created this new dot PS file. Yeah, so from a tech file, we can go to at least PS, PDF, DVI. But for HTML purposes, you might want to convert it to a HTML file. There are LaTeX to HTML, LaTeX to MAN. There's a MAN, LaTeX to MAN, LaTeX to HTML is also a program that takes a tech file and creates the HTML file directly. Yeah, it has not been installed on this computer. That is why it will say that look, it is not currently installed. But I am sure that this is the command one can use to create a tech file directly to HTML file. There is also a LaTeX to RST. Yeah. So for those who already know, there is something called new. There is a RST file. RST is also what, report lab structured text. Another relatively recent way of writing a very plain text file using any editor of your choice, from which you can create a PDF file directly, you can create a HTML file directly. And RST, just like tech file, is a very small file. The file size is very small, but lot of formatting etcetera can be done. And RST is not so well suited for math, for mathematical equations, but otherwise I personally use RST for many purposes. After recently I came to know about RST. So RST is another structured text. So report lab structured text is a full form of RST, and that's built on Python. Many in our FOSI project know about RST. That's how I picked up about RST. So one can convert from tech to RST also. Once it is RST, one can go from RST to many other. HTML is possible, PDF file is of course possible. So these all formats are compatible with each other. From RST, one can also go to a so-called ODT file. ODT means Open Office Document. From RST, one can go to ODT. Maybe it is not there. RST is there here. RST to ODT is possible. And once it is ODT, you can all agree that you can open it in Open Office and save it as a doc file, as a Microsoft Word doc file. From ODT, one can go to doc file. Yeah. So there is a long chain of various intercompatibilities of extensions about file formats. But then we are interested in LaTeX, so we will convert it to just PDF file. Yeah. So before we answer some more questions, it appears like there is a question from St. Joseph College, Kerala. So we will just take that question before we answer other questions.
Sir, two questions. When we select a particular document class, we get a margin set up. How to make it a conventional or custom margin second question is how to alter the orientation, as that is printing in landscape to portrait change.
So the two questions from St. Joseph Kellam was about how to set the margins from default margins to other margins. For example, I personally, when I print the drafts of my papers, I leave very less margin in order to save paper. Yeah, so what if paper is provided free? Still, why waste so much margins on the sides? So I leave very less margin. How to set the margins? How to also make the lines come closer to each other? Yeah, if you are just interested in giving somebody a printout of some text just for record, you may not want so much line spacing between lines. How to change that? This is very much doable. How to set the margins is just some command called odd side margin, even side margin, top margin, text height, text width. These are some commands about which we can show quickly later. Another question was about how to make it in landscape or portrait mode. So default is portrait mode. If you want landscape, landscape option is there. Landscape option is there. Also, when you want to include a figure into your document and you want to turn the figure, yeah, by 90 degrees, the landscape portrait modes are very much adjustable, doable, and just some small change in the top in document class, perhaps you can set mode equal to landscape or portrait. Such small changes will change it to portrait mode, to landscape mode. Default is of course portrait. Are there any more questions from Kerala?
My question was in Microsoft Word we can change the page layout of one page in a document where all other pages are in portrait mode and one of the pages in landscape mode, right, like that.
Yeah, sure. So the question is that when you make certain settings in document class, any setting that is done before begin document, those settings are applicable for the entire document. Yeah, so clearly if you want margins to be different for only one page, or you want page number to not be there only on one particular page, or only one particular page you want instead of portrait, you want landscape. For example, a big table, we want that particular table such a big, so many columns, so you want only that page to be in landscape instead of portrait. So settings for a individual page have to come after the begin document. Yeah, so using something called fancy header package, FAN, let me just type it here so that it is visible to all. So using slash fancy header, this allows one to make various settings for an individual page. Yeah, HDR actually stands for header, but not just for header, one can do plenty of changes for individual pages in which those settings are only for that page. Margin settings, landscape, portrait, all settings will be applicable only for that page. Then one can say this page style, so that it is applicable only for that particular page where that command occurs. When it is LaTeXing, if it is supposed to come near a table, then near the table you say this page style. Yeah, so these using use package fancy header, one can do a whole lot of advanced things, and this is something we will not cover in this course. Yeah, during the sessions, at least on Moodle we can take some time and answer these questions, but not on AView. Yeah, so let us if there are no more questions, then we will go back to continuing to answer the various other questions we collected so far. Okay, so then another question was, when you include graphics, what is the default extension? Should it be JPG, EPS? Do you even have to specify the extension? Or why not make LaTeX always look for a default extension? So when using a so-called declare file extensions, declare graphics files extensions, using such a command, one can say all the whenever we say figure, then figure.eps, figure.jpg, figure.gif. In this particular sequence, it will look for the figure.fig file, figure.eps file. So one can use declare file extensions command on the top. Exactly how to do this, I have to open one of my own template tech files, but we can answer this on Moodle certainly. Another question is, in IEEE papers, you often require two columns. Yeah, let us see an example here. For example, this particular PDF file, here there are two columns. This is what, because this has been prepared for a particular conference paper, so it has two columns. So if you use instead of document class, report, book, article, instead of this default that we showed, if you use IEEE TRAN, for example, or IEEE CONF, these are also CLS files, these are also class files which are not default in LaTeX. Yeah, after all, IEEE is a company, it is a corporate, while LaTeX is open source. When in LaTeX installation, why should IEEE class file come? Yeah, for example, Elsevier is another publishing company, they publish their own journals. They are a private company after all. Why should FOSS installation like LaTeX install Elsevier CLS file, or why should they install IEEE class file? It will not come, but on IEEE journals it will be, it will tell explicitly, if you are compiling using LaTeX, then please download this class file, and in the document slash document class you can put IEEE class. Yeah, for example, the particular class, the particular class file is not on this computer now. We can so let us go back to this. So perhaps here instead of article, one has to use IEEE conf. Yeah, after you have put the IEEE conf dot cls file inside one of your LaTeX directories, then when you compile this, it will automatically do it according to IEEE format. IEEE format default is two columns. If you do not want two columns, you can also use slash one column command and do this. Yeah, default is two columns, but for our article, it will article also, if you want two columns, one can just do this. After begin abstract, one can say from here we want two column. Yeah, please note, I am not using IEEE now, because IEEE may not be on this computer, it does not come in the default LaTeX installation. Why do not we LaTeX this and see. So so here it has put everything from here on in just in two column. There is enough, there is not enough text to go to the second column, that is why it has come only on the first column. Moreover, you will notice that it does not shift from one column to two column in the middle of a page. Yeah, why, some part was already written in one column format, and then suddenly we said we want two column, it will not shift. Yeah, so these are some intricacies of the article CLS file. How the two column will have its effect is defined inside the CLS file. We chose document class article, so inside the article.cls there will be some such. Yeah, you are encouraged to see the CLS file yourself. Where is the CLS file? That information is what you can see from the log file. Yeah, so grep article glimpse log. Look, it says that because you said article, it has picked the article from this particular place. Yeah, when you say article document, document class article, default is CLS extension. These are some other extensions which are not relevant for the default LaTeX user. Yeah, after many years of using LaTeX, I came to know about this. It is not so urgent. If you want to see what is in the CLS file, then you are encouraged to look for this particular file and open it, not during the sessions, later on. Typically the commands here are plain tech commands, not LaTeX, but just tech. The tech is on what LaTeX has been built. We will not entertain questions about the difference between tech and LaTeX in this AVU. Okay, another question was, how do you get different fonts? Times Roman, italics, emphasis are the only fonts you have seen so far. How do you get all other various fonts, calligraphic fonts, some of the fonts we already saw in one of the PDF files in the beginning today. In particular, how do you get Devanagari? Yeah, so let me tell you, there are plenty of fonts already in LaTeX contributed by volunteers. Yeah, there is no company that makes Devanagari fonts for LaTeX, contributed by various people, individuals. Devanagari is possible. I have used it myself for Hindi. Arabic font is possible. I have used it myself for Urdu. I am also sure that Tamil, Malayalam, Bengali, Telugu fonts are possible. Marathi and Hindi, of course, are Devanagari fonts. Plenty of these fonts are possible, not just across India, across the world. So, Arabic, within Arabic, there is a Urdu plugin by which we can write in plain text and then convert it to Urdu in LaTeX. So, these are things that I have used myself, and this is already 10 years ago. So, I am sure it is possible in much more easy way now. Okay, so Devanagari is possible, but we will not cover it in AVU. About Devanagari, we recommend that you look on the net yourself. We will not entertain those questions on Moodle also. Now, as far as the question about chapter, there is no space, because at the beginning of the paragraph, immediately following a section or a chapter, no space is left. This is indeed a question we tried to answer. Yeah, let us look at the document here. So, look at this document. So, this section has started here. This space, there is no paragraph indentation here, even though we put slash par indent. But this is the next paragraph, because there was an empty line. Because there was an empty line, this line here has not been completed. That line has been left like that, and a new line has been started. And here there is some empty space. This is the default paragraph indent space. How do you get the space here? It appears like it is a convention that in the beginning of the chapter, beginning of the section, indentation is not required in the beginning of that paragraph. That is why par indent is disabled there. If you really want a space and you know what you are doing, for a particular paper you are submitting, maybe you are sure that you need space, just put slash a space 1 cm, 3 cm. We like 3 centimeters of space, h for horizontal, h space, horizontal space, and there is also v space, as you can guess. In such places, wherever there is space, better to put a star. Star here means, it does not mean that numbering has been disabled. Why? Because for space anyway, no number is generated. Star here means you want the space precisely here. Whenever you are introducing all these spaces, I told multiple spaces are same as one single space, but if you put the star there, then the space will come precisely where you have put this command. Now, let us save this and compile this. Now, let us see, it has left a whole 3 centimeters of space here. Yeah. So, if you really want to force LaTeX to put space where you want, you are free to use slash h space. Yeah, sometimes we really require to put this h space. This is how you can put the space. So, slash h space is what you can use to put space wherever you want, not just h. H is for horizontal, you can also put vertical space. For example, many years ago when I used to make figures by hand, by draw the figures on hand and then paste it inside a LaTeX document. That time you have to just leave some vertical space and you stick it and then give it for Xerox. Yeah, so, in such a place you have to use V space command. So, V space star will leave 3 centimeters, 4 centimeters of vertical space. Right now, we have left only horizontal space. Yeah. So, another question that was there here was that if you want alignment, neither left nor right, neither flush left nor flush right, but some spaces in the middle, then you can use the slash h space. Yeah, what h space does not do is, it will put spaces only on the beginning of that line. Rest of it is just like, yeah, it is all indented, they are all the same, left margin is left. If you want to put a whole block with more paragraphs, you can use some begin block, end block. Yeah. If you want to make a smaller page that fits on the top, center, left, right, center, a whole page that is left exactly 2 centimeters further margin from the left side, there is something called mini page, a begin mini page, end mini page will answer this. This is also something we will not answer on during in the sessions. Yeah, there is something called mini page for those who are taking note. Let me just clarify, slash begin mini page. Yeah, text that becomes a mini page, and this mini page is like some block that gets created by LaTeX. that can be shuffled left, right. Yeah, you can say h space, h space 4 centimeters. This will be 4, that whole page will get shifted 4 centimeters to the right, because you have left 4 centimeters before this. Yeah, so this is how one can do more advanced shifting of pages, shifting of a small block of text inside a bigger page. So whether mini page requires some more use packages or not is something that is best found on the net. Okay, so we will not cover this in our course. I think that answers all the questions that were asked. Fonts, Devanagari, Arabic we will not cover, but Roman and some other fonts is certainly we will cover in this course. That is what we had started seeing. Okay, so let's go back to the slash begin flush right date 19th, today is, let's say, 13th November. So let us see where that date has come. So this space before the date has got left. Why has that, how much space to leave? 2 centimeters, 3 centimeters, 4 centimeters. Do we have to do trial and error about how much space to leave? No, we had already decided that look, on this side it should be aligned to the right side. Yeah, that in other words, it has to be flushed. It has to be flushed to the right side as much as possible until it hits the margins. Yeah, that is a begin flush right, end flush right. Whatever you put in the middle will get flushed. You might also want to fill some horizontal space. This is something we do in the end of proofs. E what? QED. Some Latin set of words abbreviated as QED. I think quid estem dictum, something like that. We all in India luckily don't have to learn Latin. It's already advantageous that we know English. So H fill has not worked the way I want. Maybe it's double L. In case somebody knows about this, please answer. So we need some time. It has left some space. Only that I don't know how it has worked. We need some time to answer this, and then we will explain about this back in the course. Yeah. Okay. So we'll go to the next topic about typewriter font. Boldface, how to put dashes, hyphens, text, slash text. After text comes the name of the font, TT. So please note there are 3 T's here, there are 3 consecutive T's here. Text TT. TT stands for typewriter font. In typewriter, we all know that font comes from one place and the on the thing that moves more and more, the cylinder moves more and more right as soon as you press a character. And how much it moves is a fixed amount, independent of whether this character requires more space or less space. In that sense, typewriter font is so called fixed width font. Every font has the same width, and then it appears like typewriter. For email addresses, we often put typewriter font. Text TT will put the content that is to be given as an argument to this command in typewriter font. Text BF will put it in boldface font. Text BF is same as slash BF. Slash BF is what we have already used. In fact, I don't even know what the difference is. It always works exactly the same. Maybe in math mode it is different. This is text, meaning it is not math, it's plain text. In math mode, the effect might be different. Notice that for slash BF we didn't give as a argument. Yeah, we enclosed it between curly brackets. What is the difference between them is what we will see now. Let us go here. Text TT, example of typewriter font. Yeah, the same thing we are putting as another one, but this time not as argument. This time not as an argument to the text tt command, but it is enclosed between curly brackets. Example of regular text, no font change. Yeah, well, why don't we see BF also together? What have we seen? What have we typed in the tech file? Text, and then two T's. Text TT is now taking something as an argument to this command. On the other hand, this particular command is not taking this as an argument. Yeah, it is just a command after which there is no argument. Why? I said that argument has to come between curly brackets to that command. There should be no space there. Single space or no space is really different. Single space is same as any number of more spaces, but whether you put a space here or not matters much. So here we have put it between curly brackets. Here text BF, we are doing the same thing for text BF. Why don't we change this? Example of boldface font. Yeah. And then this one is regular font. Now we will see the effect of various things. First let us compile this. So there is some other error that has come in. So curly bracket instead of round bracket was giving some errors. Here we have this. First example of typewriter font, example of boldface font, and this is just regular font. Yeah. These are three different fonts that has come. Of course, in all three cases, the argument, whatever text you wanted in a different font, was given as an argument. That is because we commented out something. Why don't we uncomment it and compile again? So text TT seems to require it to be given as an argument only. That is the conclusion of this experiment. That if you don't give it in, if you don't give it as a argument, only the first letter comes in the required font. Rest of it doesn't come in a different font, surprisingly. But that is for text TT. So that is indeed different between text TT and just TT, between text BF and just BF. Yeah, as an example of teaching this particular topic, I have come to know of this important difference between text TT and TT. Text TT has to take as an argument, and if you don't give an argument, then only the first letter comes in that different font. Yeah, but on the other hand, just TT or just BF will work between curly brackets. After you close the curly bracket, look, this has come in just regular text. This has come in regular font, because whatever that BF environment, it ended inside the curly brackets. Yeah, so these are the different fonts we have seen. What about underline? Also note that if you forget to close the curly bracket, yeah, if you don't put curly bracket, for example, let us see an example. Here we have started slash BF, and after that the slash BF was not enclosed between curly brackets. And the purpose of this experiment is that this slash BF, yeah, will not have an effect on this. Why? Because this particular thing has been given as an argument to this. Yeah, if it is BF, then you will not see the change for text TT, for example. But this one, that BF continues to be applicable for this also. Yeah, these are some small subtle things. Look, this one came in bold, this one came in typewriter, because we changed, actually we changed text TT, even though we forgot to change this word here. This one continues to be in boldface font, because we did not put those curly brackets. Yeah, these are some small, if you have not understood this, don't worry about it, it is not too critical. If you want dash, then just put a two consecutive hyphens, will put a little larger dash. Single dash will put just a small hyphen, small hyphen dash M dash for a larger dash. Enumerate, yeah, come now comes the important things. Enumerate, itemize, these other environments is what we will start seeing now. Yeah, notice that in our original sample document we had those things also. So why don't we remove these extra things we introduced now? Sub packages, yeah, there's some table here. Item 4, item 56, so begin itemize. Itemize means bullets, default itemize means just bullets. Notice that I had commented out that I had commented that listing, and we actually have in our tech file something that requires that listing. That is why it has given some errors. So why don't I end the document right here. So here, because of the begin document, it has put these bullets, it has put all these items. Yeah, item 4, item 56, this is some text I typed. Yeah, the important is it is not numbered, they just come as big dots. If you want some other symbol to come instead of dot, that is also, you can put almost any symbol that you require. So that can be specified as optional arguments to item between square brackets. As I said, all optional arguments come between square brackets. Default is dot. Instead of dots, if you want them to be numbered, if you want them to be numbered as 1, 2, 3, then all you have to do is enumerate. So these both are called lists. Begin itemize, begin enumerate. Enumerate and itemize are something called a list. So inside a list you have to have this item. These are the items that you want to be listed, either with bullets or with numbers. So now we have put numbers. So here we have listed them, because we want them to be enumerated, we chose begin enumerate. Only a small change on the top, and suddenly all bullets have been replaced by numbers. Yeah, also some indentation has been provided. Yeah, we can see lot of much more text and see what happens. Suppose we have much more text, then is indenting applicable? How is the indenting? Yeah, this some text I have put just to make it larger. So this is how it has come. Suppose we have much more text on the right side, it has gone up to the others, yeah, but on the left side there is some indenting. First of all, this indenting has come just like for bullets or enumerate. This dot also has come, one, numbers, they are all increasing by themselves. You can put a label, you can pick out the numbers so that you are referring to it from somewhere else. How to give labels and refs, that is something we will see very soon, perhaps immediately after lunch. This is aligned, yeah, that some, this much space has been provided. How to increase the space, how to decrease it, negative space is all possible. You for certain papers I wanted to squeeze to lesser number of pages, so I change all these indent values, the spacings is all changeable. Yeah, this is how indenting is done in listings. You can also nest these listings one inside another. Yeah, inside this you can start another. Let's say here, begin enumerate. You can put a comment. Second one, second enumerate. Then these items are automatically applicable for the second one. Yeah, how to automatically get this indenting? That depends on the editor. PDF LaTeX, LaTeX does not require any indenting. Yeah, Python programming language certainly requires indenting, but LaTeX, PDF LaTeX do not require it to be indented. For your ease of readability, if you want this indent, then you should use a good editor. Yeah, inside Vim one can use something called LaTeX suite, and one can get this extra indentings done. So this indenting inside the tech file is optional. But when you do PDF LaTeX, it will indent the eventual output back to the upper enumerate. You can also put a comment here. Second enumerate ends. So please note, this is our tech file. Enumerates have been nested. There's one enumerate here. One item was already there. Second item was also already there. Third item itself is an enumerated list. Yeah, and the fourth one is the original one. Second enumerate has two sub items. Sub item is what we are calling for convenience. This item it will also be called item only. Slash item is a command. Why don't we save this? Let us see our output argument. First one it has chosen as 1, 2, 3, 4. For the second, it has itself chosen A and B. Yeah, there is no point in choosing again 1, 2, there will be a lot of confusion. Yeah, so it has changed from Arabic numerals to then alphabets. If you want this to be in a different way, that setting is possible. Then this has come back to this. Notice that all this has got indented further. Of course, you can also have some regular text in this space. Regular text and then enumerate. What if we do not leave a new line? So, it has said regular text and then enumerate. Incidentally, the page has changed there. And then the enumerate has started with that same indenting that you had seen before. Yeah. Can you nest only enumerates inside enumerates? Can you nest enumerate inside itemize? Can you nest itemize inside enumerate? All these things are possible. You can make the outer one as itemize. If you make the outer one as itemize, then the inner one numbering will change from. Yeah, the outer one has become itemized, that is why dots have come, and so the inner one has become 1, 2. Yeah, you can also make the outer one as enumerate and inside one as itemized. You can have another nest inside. You can do any number of nestings like this, only that there should be enough different numbers to choose. One is numbers 1, 2, 3, then is alphabets, then Roman numerals, plenty are available. Capital, small letters are available, different font numbers are possible. You can also set it if you do not want, but this is a little touchy thing. Suppose we want something else here, we want all this to be percent. Yeah, if you put a percent, immediately it becomes a comment. You can put a slash, only the first one is going to be, instead of bullet there will be a slash. But this is really an advanced thing and do not worry about it. Yeah, here bullet has changed to percent. We have to put slash percent, so that the percent does not act like a comment, rest are dots. You can use the same percent symbol for everything else also. This is one way that you can put, but in enumerate you cannot choose it so directly, it has to be set differently because the numbers are going to be different. Yeah, you cannot set that as easily. Okay, so that completes lists for enumerate and itemize. These are the ones that we use most. If there are any more, if there are any questions, we will take the questions now. So there's a question about giving an example of using two different languages in a single document. So this is something I have done myself for Urdu and Devanagari, but that's 8 years ago, and I think that one should take a lot of care when using different scripts, because even for BF and TT, I already showed you how whether it is given as an argument or whether you open the curly bracket but don't close it. These are going to have lot of difficulties in the rest of the document, and one should pay lot of attention to this. So lot of care has to be taken indeed in doing it in the same document. What I had done for convenience is I did them as separate documents, and I merged the PDF files. I got the second of the two documents to have a page number that continues from the end of the first one, and then I had merged the two PDF files because I was not sure how to use them in the same document. But this is already 8 years ago. I am sure it is possible to do better now. One important question is, can we start the itemized list starting from any number rather than one only? Yeah. So this is an extremely good question. One question that has come in chat is, can we start the itemized lists starting from not just 1, 2, 3, but from some other number? Yeah, this is very much doable. So what you have to do is you have to set the counter. There is a counter for page number, counter for, we already saw, sec num depth. There is a counter for all the lists, each sub list new counter. There is a counter for chapter number, section number. Each of these counters have a default that they start from 1, but every counter can be set using set counter. Set counter, name of the counter that you want to change, set to some other one, footnote for example, reference, all these can be set to whatever number you want using the set counter command. Yeah, beyond this we will not be able to answer now, because I need to look up myself. Another question is how to have different types of bullets. So let's come back to this particular presentation. Let's come back to this PDF file. Here, this is what we will call bullet. Yeah, bullet is the default in itemize only. In enumerate, we will have numbers, or we will have alphabets. These are running; they are changing from item to item. Yeah, each of this is anyway called an item. Yeah. But this particular symbol here is called bullet. This one is called percent. When is it called bullet? It's called bullet here. Here we will not call this bullet. Yeah, these are numbers. Instead of Arabic numbers 1, 2, if you want Roman numbers, if you want alphabets, those things can be set. Those can be set. But then I have not done that myself. One has to see enumerate. One has to see more details about the enumerate list. Either you can open the article.cls file itself and see how this enumerate listing has been defined, because it could be different, for example, in IEEE conf. Easier is to just look on the net. Yeah, even though this detailed information will certainly be there in the class file, in article class file. That is where all this enumerate, what numbers to choose as default, inside enumerate, if you use another nested enumerate, what new number it should shift to, all that is certainly written in enumerate list settings inside the class file. But instead of reading that, it's easier to just look on the net. Yeah, these are the two places where you can see, because I don't know about this now. So there are some questions from Kolhapur. Okay, please ask your question.
Okay, sir, my question is how to define Roman numbers for customized list. Number list.
His question is that inside a enumerated list, instead of 1, 2, 3, if you want Roman letters, yeah. So if you want Roman letters, then some particular setting has to be changed. After you do begin enumerate, you have to just reset something. This we need some time. I have forgotten about this. I will check this and tell you later today afternoon. Yeah, this is very much doable. Any other question? The question is that we want to write something in superscript, subscript, and I had been saying that LaTeX is most useful for mathematical things in which we will have lots of superscript, subscript, and I have not even told you that yet. Of course, this is a question that we will answer right now, even though we will certainly see it in much more detail later. We will answer this question right now. Yeah. So let us go back to the tech file. Are there any other questions from Bhopal?
Question is that how to set the margin of the paper as per IEEE format?
Question
the margin
is
given just like 0.75 and 0.25 in between two columns.
So the question is how to set the margins according to IEEE conference or IEEE transactions, journal transactions, how to set the margins to those values. So that question we will answer now. How to get the two column also we have answered, but we will see that in more detail. Are there any other questions from Bhopal?
Hello. While typing down the thing in IEEE format, it is required that the thing should be in two columns. And if the figure is or the table which we want to type is more than two columns, that is more than a single column, can we reduce it and put it in that particular format?
Yeah. So the other question is that IEEE wants everything to be in two columns, only the final version I should say. Yeah, the earlier versions don't have to be in two columns. The final versions and the conference submission have to be in two columns. But if the table, if a table is very wide for half of the page, yeah, typically tables are wider than half the page, and in single, it will not fit in one of the two columns. In a two column format, it will not fit in such thin space. Then what to do? Yeah, IEEE requires that only that part you do for the full column. That is really the hardest part, to make only part of it go for one column, rest of it to come in two columns. This is indeed a very difficult thing, and we will try to answer now. Okay, the next question is from Srinagar. Please ask. Footnote for a whole document, I did not understand. What is the meaning of a footnote for the entire document? Footnote at a particular part in the text, if there is some extra information you want to provide, which is not so important that you will put in the paragraph, then you will put a footnote, and just at the bottom of that page only you require the footnote. For the entire document means what? It should come at the end of the document, or the footnote should all come together at the end. Is that what you want to ask?
Yes, so some information we need to actually, that should be uniform across the document, and we actually generally put it in the footnote, kind of a footer in Microsoft Word.
So the question is, see, footnote we would like to say is a note, a small note inside a piece of text which is less important, that is why it will be just one small sentence, two, three sentences at the bottom of only that page. This is different from header and footer, which is applicable for all the pages. For example, we want to say that on every page we want to say the title of the document, author. Yeah, for example, page numbers. Somebody has asked how to remove the page numbers and not have page numbers. Somebody might say the page number should come in the header, not the footer. So that header footer is applicable for all the pages, and that is best set using the fancy header package I told about. Yeah, fancy header is an optional one. It doesn't come in the default LaTeX installation, or maybe nowadays it does. Fancy header will allow you to set the header footer for odd pages, even pages, bottom of all pages, footer of all pages, whether the page number should come inside the header or not. Those all are possible using the fancy header command, fancy header use package. Okay, so from that we'll disconnect. Are there any other questions from Srinagar?
So does LaTeX support any other language apart from English, and how do we specify that particular language in the document?
So one can, as I said, I have used Urdu Devanagari. One can use many scripts. You write in plain English text. Unfortunately, our keyboard is most likely an English keyboard. So you enter the text using English letters, and the final document will be generated like it is in, let's say, like it's in Devanagari. Not just Devanagari, Telugu, Malayalam, Tamil, Bengali. many such languages are possible, I am sure. What all languages are possible? Internet is the best resource. At this point, I do not know. But the final, this is for the script of the final document. The text, the tech file itself has to be in the letters we know, English letters. Yeah, that I do not think there is an option there. Yeah. Oh, are there any other questions before we disconnect from Srinagar?
Sir, one more question. So, which is how can we manage the width between the space between two columns? If we want to enlarge the space or you want to reduce the space between two columns of a document?
So his question is that in case we have IEEE style, for example, where you have two column format, then IEEE, when you submit it, they will check whether you have left the margins correctly or not. Yeah, because for extra pages you have to pay a lot of money. So what people do, they just decrease the side margin so that it fits in the correct number of pages. So they have an auto checker whether it, whether the margins have the right spacing or not, whether the content fits in the correct spacing or not. But luckily what IEEE does not do is it does not check the middle margin, whether the correct amount of space has been left in the middle or not. So perhaps it is possible to decrease the middle margin so that you can squeeze in more text per page, and it is indeed possible. Yeah. So middle margin, some particular command will stand for the middle margin. Yeah, and these commands are all very self-explanatory. So IEEE conf.cls, this is the class file one has to download from the net in order to use IEEE style. Yeah, all the margins then automatically get set. IEEE conf decides how much margins have to be set, and inside that some particular variable will be there for which we can change it to more or less. Yeah, this is certainly doable, and I have done this in the past, but I do not remember which particular command to use for this, but there is enough help on the net about this and I am sure it is possible. Okay, so we do not have any more time to take questions now, but we will take the questions that are on chat the first thing immediately when we start after the lunch.